guys, it's Melissa in this video, which is number two of my Silhouette SyncGate 2024 series. We are going to talk about how to actually export your entire library in its current file structure so that you can create your own file system. This is going to be a lifesaver for you if you can't access your full library, if you're having trouble. I will say, if you haven't started with video number one about how to stop those syncing errors, I would definitely do that first. It is the first video in this series, and I will link it for you in the description and up top. Start there and then do this second step. Let's go.
All right, so here's what you are going to do. You are going to go back to your library. And again, you need to be making sure that you're working offline. So we are literally just going to export the library. So if you're having issues accessing your library, this is all we're gonna do. And we're gonna put this onto another system, like in Google Drive or on your external hard drive or even just on your computer itself. So all you're going to do is click your name and you're going to click Export User Created Files. This is literally going to download anything in your library that either you imported or you created and saved to your library. And it's going to export it in the folders that they're in the folder structure that they're in, and in a format that you can access, as long as they're not Silhouette Studio files, or they will be, but you could still at least have them off out of the library. If they're SVGs, PNGs, you'll be able to access them in other programs as well. So first thing, just browse your computer. This is literally just telling it where you want to place the file. So you click open, and this is where it's going to go. I really don't know why it says browse computer. You're just directing it of where on your computer to go. You're not like navigating to find something on your computer. Then you're just gonna click export. You can see it's exporting my entire library. So one, again, when this is done, and it might not be that 4,562 show up. Do you see how there's like a slight discrepancy here, like three of them? I'm honestly not going to worry about it, but it is telling me which ones it couldn't do. All right. So then all I have to do is go over here to downloads, and here is my whole folder. All right. So, or my whole library. This is my library. My Silhouette Studio library. All right, so what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna show you quickly, is if I go in, and here is the folder structure, which perfectly matches the structure that I have over here. I'm just gonna click it so you can see that it's exactly the same. See how 3D, 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 blah, 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 all the way down the line. All you have to do then is click finish. Okay, so now all of your files are on your computer. You can then move them, and I would suggest this, move them to a Google Drive or something like that, and use that to basically start your own file organization system. Now, how do you then open those files? So a lot of people for some reason don't realize that you really don't even need to use the Silhouette Studio library. So the library right now that's syncing with the cloud is causing a lot of issues, but in general, having a lot in your library anyway is risky because of things like this, but also it just is a lot of extra data that's in Silhouette Studio. So let's say now you wanna figure out how to access something that was one of your designs. So you'll just navigate on your computer. I'm just gonna find something. Here's an SVG. So I can literally just drag and drop, and there is the file. Now there's other ways to open them as well. You could go to open, again, navigate to where your designs are. So I will just find anything in here. These are all kinds of, look, you see, do you see how it's like subfolders and folders? So I'll just pick one that I want to open, and it opens there, and you have your design there. This is an SVG that I can then go and cut. So if I go to the send panel, it's gonna be the same as it would as if I was getting it from my library. So I'll get it here. You can see, here's the same file. Here it is from the library. Here it is from my computer, literally the exact same file. So you do not need to use the Silhouette Studio library. And even if you have been using the Silhouette Studio library, you can export it. The only things that are not going to export from your library at this point are the files that you got from your Silhouette If you bought files from the Silhouette Design Store, if you did those will not export. And if you try to export your library using Library Export, it's going to export in this file type called, it's going to export in a file type that you basically can't use other than to just re-import it. So it's not like you would be able to open that file and see all your full files in there. It's a bunch of, you know, code. Now, if you want to download your files from the Silhouette Store, your orders from the Silhouette Store, because they're currently not syncing into your library, I'm going to have another video, the third in this series, on that, and you can watch that right after this.